Hello friends, welcome on this video tutorial. Daniel is here today on tips to fix, and I will talk about installing Windows 11 on unsupported computers. I will show you a new method to install and all methods to install Windows 11. I have a lot of questions and I see a lot of difficulties from you guys to install it on unsupported hardwares. I see the comments on the other video tutorial that I did before, but I will do this updated video for all of you guys that you're trying to install and you see the error, and I will show you every single details, what you have to do and how to make it possible to install on your computer. I'll show you the first method using Rufus. I will show you the second method using Registry Key Editor, like Microsoft is suggesting. And I will show you the third one, the easiest one that I did in the other video tutorial, replacing that appraisers.dll, and then I will show you how to install without any issue or any error like you did before. It's because Windows 11 did some updates and changes and things, and we really need to make this video tutorial again because they did those updates. So let's go directly to the point and let's start with method one, installing Windows 11 on unsupported computers. Okay, first thing we have to do, I will show you here, I'm on Windows 10, I'm on the last version of Windows 10, you see my update is here, and my processor is not supported, as you know. If you go here on Windows Update, check for updates, then you will see here a message. Get ready for Windows 11. To see if this PC can run Windows 11, then check the hardware requirement to visit PC manufacturer. Click here the website and open up. I will check the compatibility here. I will download the PC health checker. Okay, download the PC health checker, and I will show you exactly that my computer does not meet system requirements. Check now. You see my processor is punishing me in this case. They didn't do any update for this kind of processor, and it's amazing processor, okay? If you wanted to know how to enable TPM 2.0 or Secure Boot, then follow the other video tutorial, check here on the info cards up there. Let's close this and let's go with method one. Method one, we will use Rufus. Okay, let's go and download Rufus. Rufus create bootable USB drive. To use Rufus, you need to have a flash drive, but make sure it's 8 GB, not less than 8, okay? This one is 32 gigs. Make sure you have Rufus 3.18 beta version, okay, guys? Pre-release, download it right now. When you see the video, maybe this version will be not pre-released, but it will be stable release. Make sure it's 3.18 or up, okay? Download the Rufus and open up Rufus, and here it is. You won't allow Rufus, yep. We just go here on download Windows 11 and then go all the way down to download the Windows 11 and then choose one. I will choose English here and then confirm. So as you see, Windows 11 is only on 64-bit processors. Okay, let's click and let's download Windows 11 image. Okay, after we download Windows 11 image ISO file, and I have it here on desktop. Let's put it here on Rufus. Go here on the boot selection drive, click select. And here on downloads or desktop is the same thing. Open up. And then here you will see image options. So this is the amazing thing that I really like on this software. You will see here image options. Here on the image options, you will see how do you want this image to be burned on the USB drive with TPM 2.0 plus secure boot or no TPM, no secure boot. Okay, and I will choose this one, no TPM and no secure boot. Okay, make sure you put the USB drive now on your computer. I have here, in fact, I have the other one, this 64 gigabytes USB. I will use MBR. And then click start and then click OK, and here it is. It will format my USB drive. With this USB bootable, you can install Windows 11, clean install, or you can upgrade it. In my case, I will try to upgrade from here directly. I will write it on USB and I will open up the USB without restarting computer and try not to clean install, but to upgrade Windows 10. Yes, for sure, without losing any data. We don't have to lose any data, okay? This will be upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11. Okay, after process is done, that what we have to do, just this USB drive, just, and I will try to set up directly and see, install better. I don't want this message. Change how setup downloads updates. I don't want any download or any update, okay? I just click here, not right now. Click next. It's checking your PC. And I know my PC doesn't meet the system requirement. Oh, look at this. Click accept. Making sure, as you see, guys, ready to install, okay? Install Windows 11 Pro. Keep the personal files and apps. Change what to keep. Keep nothing, keep personal files only, but I wanted to keep personal files and apps, everything. Make sure you are ready to install, making sure your PC. If I hit install right now, the process will start installing. Let's try. Look at this, guys. It starts to install Windows 11. I will cancel it. I don't want it right now. Let me show you how it will look if I don't use Rufus. Let's start directly from this image, without any changes, without Rufus. Click mount, here it is, and try to install, and you will see that error doesn't let me to install. Install Windows 11, I don't want this, and I don't want this. Click next, checking your PC. This is the original copy, without any changes on the setup. And let's see if I am able to install directly from original copy. As you see, guys, the processor isn't supported for this version of Windows. So let's go on directly and see the other method. So the other method, I called method 2, is the official one. I mean, the one that is suggested by Microsoft. It's not recommended, but they show the way how to do it. Okay, based on the Microsoft. If we make these changes on the registry key, then you will be able to install it without using any other software. This method will be very easy. Go here on run and search for regedit, and then here on the regedit registry editor, what we have to do, just go here on HK local machine system setup, HK local machine system and setup. Here, mall setup. What is? Go here on a move setup. Right click it, and create dwarfed 32-bit value and name it. This is the name. Okay, look at this. Allow upgrades with unsupported TPM or CPU. Okay, click enter, and then double click it here and click the value data to 1. Okay, now we did this. So what we gotta do, you have to mount this disk that we downloaded. It's untouched, it's the original one that we download from Microsoft, and double click to install it. Let's see, change how setups, that's okay. Click next. If it's any update, that let's try, why not. In this case, check for updates. I don't think it's any update there. Oh, okay, updates are installed, but Windows 11 setup needs to restart. That's great, okay. Again, checking your PC. Let's check my PC now, after I did these changes on the registry editor. Oh, great. Great method. Easy. Click accept. Making sure you're ready to install, getting updates. Checking for updates. I don't need that. You have to disable this. Making sure you're ready to install. So if you see this message, what needs your attention, you have to click accept here. and then making sure you have enough space. So now we are ready to install, okay? And then click install, boom, here, and the installation starts directly. I will cancel it because I don't want it to install right now. I have to show you the third method, so I will cancel installation, right? Okay, quick. Please wait while setup is exit. So, I will make your life easier, guys. If you like to install Windows 11 with official method, like Microsoft is suggesting, that you are not good on doing this registry editor, editing and creating files, and if this is too much for you, what I have to do for you guys, I will export this registry key and I will make it able for you to download it and just double click it, go install Windows 11. I will put the name here, save it. Here it is. Here is the key that I created. What I gotta do, I will delete it here and then I will double click it here, click yes, click OK, and you see it's here. It's here. Let's try again if the setup well works. Remove this and remove. We don't have time for this. Click OK. Checking your PC. We are getting a few things ready. Click accept, making sure you're ready to install. So, and click accept here. Click install, and that's it. I will close this method now. Okay, the third method that is the one that I show you in the other video tutorials, copy and replace appraisers.dll that I created for you guys to do it before. So I will do it again. Some of you have some problems doing this method and you see that doesn't work it anymore. But what I will show you is a very easy tip. Okay, what I gotta do, I just download here appraisers.dll, open up. Paste it here. Okay. And what I have to do, extract here. I extract here this ISO image of Windows 11 original copy. Good. Now, copy this appraiser, the one that you downloaded from Tips to Fix website. Open up the original copy of your Windows 11, go here on the sources, and then what you gotta do, just replace, let's try to install, and then set up, and here on the setup, what you gotta do, click get updates, not right now, because where you are getting updates right now, then it download the updates automatically, then the replacement that we did, it lost. So, and then you will see that message, you are not able to install Windows 11. Okay, so we don't have to download any updates right now because we did changes here. And I want to help make the installation better. I don't want this. Remove this. Okay, and then let's click next and see if this method is working, as you see. Okay. It's the easiest one for me. I like it better. Click accept. Click accept again. And then make sure. And then click install. And you see, if I click install, it starts installation normally. I will cancel it because I don't need to install it right now. So what I have to do for you guys, I will collect all of these tools, Windows 11 tools, collect it together, and I will make it able for you to download it and have it on your computer. Here it is. You will be able to download all of these files here on this zip file, and then you have to download the latest version of Windows 11 from Windows 11 website. Okay, I will install Windows 11 and let's see it how it works with method 1 with Rufus, and let's see on the action. Okay. Okay, let's go on my USB drive. This one is my USB that we created with Rufus, and I have to start installation with this. I really recommend it using Rufus. It's amazing. I don't have to download anything. I will click not right now, okay? And click next. Click accept. and then click install. So we start installation Windows 11 with keeping all the files. We don't have to delete anything and we have to keep all the data inside.
Make sure you remove the USB now and your computer will be restarted many times.
Okay, here we are on Windows 11 on unsupported PC using the method with Rufus. And let's go and search for updates and see if the updates are working well. Computer updates to maintain security of your device. And then click download now. And let's see if the updates are working well. Look at this, downloading updates. So it's working well. Okay, it's working well. And I will click here, cumulative updates, download and install. Then hit the restart button here. Okay guys, as you see, everything is working great on this Windows 11 now in unsupported computers. So you have many options now how to install Windows 11 on your old computer or unsupported computer. So if you see that Windows 11 is not performing well on your computer and you wish to go back on Windows 10 without losing any data, see the next video tutorial. I will show you how to go back on Windows 10. Just click the link in the end of the video. I will show you how to extend the 10 days rollback of Windows 11 to Windows 10, okay? You only have 10 days, but I will extend this number from 10 days to 60. I will show you exactly how to do this. So thank you guys for watching this video tutorial. God bless you. See you on the next one.